Leave the gallery quickly and quietly because we are in fact about to go in to our next item of business. Thank you very much indeed for your cooperation. So the next item of business is a members' business debate on motion 12162 in the name of Karen Adam on Young Carers Action Day 2024. This debate will be concluded without any questions being put, and I would invite those members who would wish to speak in the debate to please press the request to speak buttons, and I call on Karen Adam to open the debate around 7 minutes, please.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. This is such a moving moment for me to bring this debate to the Scottish Parliament, particularly when we are welcoming dozens of young carers here today. And amongst our visitors are two very special young women who, due to their initiative, made this debate happen. And I wish to give my thanks also to their teacher for supporting them, because obviously she is doing a fantastic job, and I'm so glad they can all be with us today. I also want to dedicate my words to those young carers who are unable to be with us, perhaps because of their caring responsibilities, and to those who, without realising it, see their caregiving simply as what needs to be done in their family, without truly understanding what their role means. As a young girl, I seldom called myself a carer, but as a CODA, a child of a deaf adult, acting as an interpreter and advocating for my deaf father, as he navigated life in a hearing world, it became second nature. And as was the case for many of my CODA friends who were supporting their deaf family members. As we go about our daily routines, whether that be driving to work, dropping the kids off at school, or just nipping to the shop, around us, working quietly throughout their day, are young carers. These are children and young people whose mornings may have begun much earlier than for many of us in this chamber. In the quiet of their homes, they may have been assisting a parent with a physical disability, preparing breakfast for them and perhaps those of their siblings too, helping to wash, or offering strength and comfort to a parent grappling with mental health challenges, buffering and mitigating many of the effects that come with disability or illness. So many of those young people watching down on us in the gallery today, and countless others across Scotland, find themselves in a world where the roles are reversed. A world in which these young people, so full of love and devotion, are shouldering burdens that would weigh heavily on many adults. Imagine a young lad who, before he thinks of schoolwork or socialising with his peers, ensures his siblings' medical needs are met. The young girl who, instead of scrolling through social media, much like her peers, checks in on her mother's well-being, providing comfort and encouragement with a maturity well beyond her years. And these are not just acts of duty, but profound expressions of love and commitment performed in the backdrop of their youth. The two pupils who contacted my office to discuss the lack of resources for young carers in our area really showed their sheer determination from the outset, and their advocacy for young carers was nothing short of inspiring. We sat in my office chatting for about an hour, putting plans into action, and often I doubt I would have had that initiative to approach my elected representative at their age, let alone to meet and advocate so eloquently for the needs of others. Conversations like these stand out in our careers as parliamentarians, and it's truly a privilege to bring this debate here today and pay tribute to them. Yesterday, we marked Young Carers Action Day, and I want not just to celebrate these remarkable young individuals, although we should and often, but we must provide young carers with the support they so rightfully deserve. The theme of this year's Young Carers Action Day is Fair Futures for Young Carers, as they're fighting a battle on two fronts: managing their caregiving responsibilities and navigating the trials and tribulations of growing up. It is imperative that caring responsibilities do not become barriers to learning, earning, or simply being able to move forward in life. Yes, absolutely.
John Swinney.
I'm grateful to Karen Adam for giving way on this important topic. I took part in a question time last night on Young Carers Action Week in Perth College. And one of the points put to me was the importance of the education system understanding the circumstances of young carers and ensuring that the approach of the education system reflected and took account of those additional demands that Karen Adam is so powerfully putting on the record this afternoon. Would she agree that we need to would Karen Adam agree that it is important our education system understands the pupils that are part of our education system and their particular needs when they are young carers?
Karen Adam.
Yes, I absolutely agree with my colleague John Swinney on that point, and I'm going to discuss a little bit about education in my speech, but there needs to be allowances, provisions and extra support for these young carers, absolutely. Many young carers feel they're missing out on large parts of their childhood, and caring can also have a serious impact on a young person's health and well-being and, as my colleague pointed out, their ability to learn and their long-term future. According to Carers Trust, more than half of young carers in Scotland say they feel worried about their future. 43% of young carers and young adult carers in Scotland say that caring always or usually affects how much time they can spend with friends. It's not surprising, Presiding Officer, but it's something we must help with. And I want to dedicate a portion of my speech today on the point of the ability to learn their education. Learning environments play a crucial role in supporting and developing young people with caring responsibilities. And as such, schools, colleges and universities must be understanding but also supportive of young carers. Too many do not feel that this is currently the case. One in three say they struggle to balance their caring responsibilities with their education, and young adult carers are 38% less likely to achieve a university degree. Sadly, those caring for 34, 35 or more hours a week are 86% less likely to do so and are also 46% less likely to enter employment than their peers. We need to do our utmost to ensure that young carers have access to learning and training opportunities and that they succeed in their education and employment. They must have time to themselves, and that's so important for their mental health. Above all, young carers must feel that they have a choice in their lives. And I'm glad to see that the Scottish Government is providing a young carers grant. However, a leading carers charity says many young people who look after others do not recognise themselves as carers. And as I said earlier, they see that support they give as just a regular part of family life. So as a result, they don't know they're entitled to this benefit. So I hope that we can really promote that as much as possible today. In conclusion, Presiding Officer, the motion that we are debating today is a call to action, and not just for recognition. The care that so many of the young people in the gallery and beyond are providing to their families and the contribution that they are making to our society more broadly is invaluable. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms Adam. I now call Evelyn Tweed to be followed by Jeremy Balfour. Ms Tweed.
Thank you to my colleague Karen Adam for bringing this important debate to the Chamber today. The theme of this year's Young Carers Action Day is, as we've heard, Fair Futures for Young Carers, which is about removing barriers that young carers face that their peers may not. It was my absolute pleasure recently to visit the Stirling Young Carer Service, who work in my constituency, and I'm delighted that Esther Keane and Cara Barber are in the gallery with us today. I am also delighted that Robert Kearney also joins us with his mum, Anne. Robert volunteers with the service and was himself a young carer. We know that caring can be a very positive experience, but there can be negative impacts on young carers without the right support. And that's why organisations like the Stirling Young Carer Service are so important. They told me that young carers often experience stress, tiredness, anxiety due to their caring role. And this in turn can mean that they find it hard to concentrate at school and keep up with their schoolwork and homework. They can also feel isolated and miss out on social experiences with their peers. In Stirling constituency, we are very lucky because we have Stirling Young Carer Service who run rural groups, and I know that rurality is a barrier to accessing support. Organisations across Scotland and in Stirling are doing excellent work at breaking down these barriers. Stirling Young Carers are currently supporting over 150 young carers, 59 of whom are in rural groups. 29 are receiving one-to-one support to help them manage stress. However, they pointed out that young people can't access support if they don't know that they're actually young carers. Robert Cairney has been volunteering with Stirling Young Carer Service for 6 years, and Robert is so passionate about his volunteering. He's an amazing young man who also helped care for and support his twin brother. As a child, though, he felt it was just his brother, and it was very natural to do the things that he did for him. It was only later that he realised that by taking on such responsibilities, it actually meant he was classed as a young carer. The carers' census found that 89% of young carers experienced an impact on their emotional well-being due to their caring role. And when you don't actually know you're a young carer, you miss out on so much support, including financial support, such as the Young Carer Grant. This is especially important when 15% of young carers live in the most deprived areas in Scotland. In order to address this, Stirling Young Carers are working in schools to help spread awareness of what it means to be a young carer and designing CPD for school staff. They would also like to see mandatory training for teachers and school staff similar to that offered on safeguarding. This could make a huge difference, especially in light of research from Carers Trust Scotland, which suggests that nearly half of young carers don't often get help to balance caring and their education. Presiding Officer, I'd like to thank Stirling Young Carers and their volunteers like Robert and the thousands of young carers across Scotland for the tireless work that they do. And if you are a teenager aged between 16 and 18 with a caring role, you may be entitled to a Young Carers Grant and other support. And it's worrying that the Scottish Government figures suggest that around 25% of those eligible for a Young Carer Grant in 2022-23 did not apply. And if you're unsure and you are a local constituent of mine, please get in touch. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms Tweed. I now call Jeremy Balfour to be followed by Carol Mochin. Mr Balfour.
Thank you, Deputy Presiding Officer. And I'm delighted to speak in today's debate to support Young Carers Action Day. And can I generally thank Karen Adams for bringing forward this debate this afternoon. Young carers have something to be very proud of. They sacrifice so much to care for someone they love. These young people often certain that they have been shaped in that person that they are by their caring role. They gain a heightened sense of empathy, develop acute observation skills, and have experience that come together to form a more caring nature. This is something to celebrate, but we must all do more to support those who encounter challenges that their peers do not. It's important that we both acknowledge their different experiences and commend their hard work. And like Karen Adams, and I would want to point out that many people do not understand that they are carers. I asked my daughter recently, as she was doing up my laces, "Are you a young carer?" And she rolled her eyes and said, "No." But there are many people who do so much, whether for siblings or for parents, that are carers, that, as both former speakers have said, simply don't acknowledge. And it would be amiss of me not to take the opportunity to thank my siblings, as I grew up, for the extra support they gave me. But young carers have plenty on their plate. As well as being in school, their caring work can often involve cooking, providing emotional support, running a household, shopping, dispensing medicine, and giving personal care. In light of the Young Carers Day, it's good to take a moment to think about what a caring role means for a young person's life. For some, they struggle with being seen as different by their friends at school. It can lead to social isolation. This can be made worse by the fact that young carers often do not have as much free time to meet up with their friends as other young people do. They can sense a loss of carefreeness. They can lose that innocence much earlier than others. And we should acknowledge this and do everything we can to support them. The theme this year is Fair Futures for Young Carers. And the best way, as others have acknowledged already in this debate, is to facilitate this through education. It is so important that young carers are properly supported in school, that they are not disadvantaged for the future. We must take this need seriously, and it must not be simply heard by this Parliament, but more importantly, it must be heard by local authority education departments and head teachers and teachers at every level of school. Many of us have the privilege of every year going along to the camp that is run for young carers. But I am shocked for the last 7 years to have heard the same message, that often young carers do struggle to stay awake because they've been up all night. They do struggle to get the homework in time because they've had caring responsibilities. And often, sadly, the teachers do not take this into account, and they are disadvantaged by this. I know there are not simple answers to this, but there must be a way that we can in some way identify those who are young carers and give them the extra support that they require to make sure, as Karen Adams pointed out, they do not miss out on future job opportunities or college or universities. Presiding Officer, young carers are among the best of us, and we owe it to them to provide us as much support as we can. To this end, I would encourage everyone to sign the Young Carers Covenant and together move forward towards a fair future for young carers. It's the least they deserve. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Balfour. And I now call Cara Mochan to be followed by Gillian Mackay. Ms. Mochan.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. Can I thank Karen Adam as well for bringing this important debate to the Chamber? And on behalf of Scottish Labour, can I thank young carers across Scotland for everything that they do and reiterate our support for them. We welcome the Carers Trust annual Young Carers Action Day and recognise the impact of the work carried out by the Carers Trust across the UK, but of course specifically here in Scotland. It is right, as stated in the motion, that caring should not become a barrier to learning, earning or being able to get on in life. Although I do appreciate this may be the challenging reality for many young carers here in Scotland. And it is really incumbent on all of us in this Parliament to remove those barriers whenever we can. It is, as others have said quite apt, this year's theme is Fair Futures, because ultimately that is what it comes down to, fairness. Young carers at the moment do not get a fair deal. I think we've heard this in the Chamber today. The barriers to learning and earning means that taking on caring responsibilities means making sacrifices that will have lasting impacts. There is no equality in that, no fairness, and it is an injustice. And I think we've heard today we all are determined to help overcome this. Presiding Officer, looking at the Carers Trust's most recent report, there were some extremely concerning figures coming out of the research in Scotland, and we need to make sure that we're all aware of this. Half of young carers who work struggle to balance caring duties with paid work. Over half are stressed, usually or always, because of being a young carer, and two-thirds feel that the cost of living crisis is always or usually affecting them and their families. So important information from young carers to us, and here in this place we must take these facts seriously. It must act as a wake-up call, because these are not just figures. They represent individual stories across Scotland of young people who are genuinely struggling to balance those caring duties with work and education and who are feeling the impacts when it comes to their emotional and mental health. This is not a situation our excellent young carers should find themselves in, but it is a reality, and those in government do have to reflect on these important pieces of information. Mental health waiting lists in Scotland remain far too high, far too long, and young people continue to suffer as they wait for appointments that are needed urgently. And indeed, these challenges are exacerbated by a UK government handling the handling of the economy, which has created a cost of living crisis that does, we have heard from young carers themselves, add anxiety and stress to individuals and families. Governments must accept responsibility and accountability for their own discussions and actions, and of course their failings. And when they do this, we can then properly engage in cooperative and properly overcome these significant and worrying challenges. Presiding Officer, one further key area which has been raised by young carers and here in the Chamber tonight, today, is about the balancing of education. Schools and colleges and universities must be more flexible in supporting carers, young carers in particular, to carry out their duties but still have that crucial ability to achieve what it is that they would like to achieve. I recognise I'm running out of time. There's so much more to say in this issue, but can I once again thank Scotland's young carers for the tremendous contribution that they make to not only their families, but right across Scotland. It is important for us to hear your voices, and I think Karen Adam bringing this to the Chamber today has allowed us to do that, and I commit my party to continue and support a cross-party approach to this. Thank you, Presiding Officer.
Thank you, Ms Walken. I call Gillian Mackay to be followed by Elena Whittam. Ms Mackay.
Thanks, Presiding Officer. I thank Karen Adam for bringing this important members' debate to the Chamber, and I also wish to extend my gratitude to young carers across Scotland for the incredible work they do in looking after their loved ones, including those who are joining us in the Chamber this afternoon. Yesterday we celebrated Young Carers Action Day, and I'd like to commend the immense contribution young carers make to our society when caring for their family and loved ones. As others have said, many young carers wouldn't think twice about what it is they do, but we need to make sure that we think deeply about how we support them properly. Caring for someone should not be a barrier to equal opportunities in learning or participating in life, especially at a young age. These young carers' lives are much too often further complicated by education and employment systems that fail to identify and understand the diversity of their caring roles and respond to their support needs. We also need to ensure that we address issues for young adult carers in this regard as well. For some, when they leave school, any good support that was there stops and they need to start again at college, university or in the workplace. Carers Trust research found that 59% of young carers in Scotland care for more than 20 hours each week, with 12% spending 50 hours or more providing unpaid care on a weekly basis. I welcome the launch by Carers Trust of the first ever UK-wide covenant for young carers and young adult carers, which has been shaped by the views of more than 500 young carers. And I want to thank the Carers Trust for allowing me to join them for the launch of the covenant earlier this week, and would encourage everyone in the Chamber to sign up to it. We heard from young carers across the UK about their experience and what they want to see for young carers and young adult carers. The whole session was led by young carers who did a wonderful job articulating not only their experience, but the experience they had gathered from others. What they told us was that young carers need lasting and meaningful change. We must ensure that they remain at the forefront of policy development and have access to the support they're entitled to and deserve. In Scotland, they must have a fair chance to prosper in all aspects of their lives so they can achieve their full potential and secure a fair future. Karen Adam is also correct that we need to provide opportunities for these young people to be young people. I've been hugely privileged to attend the Young Carers Festival, which allows young carers to have a break from their caring responsibilities and a space to see friends and have their voices heard. There was also an opportunity to ask questions of MSPs, and I was struck speaking to them at the number of issues that young carers wanted to ask me about. I was totally prepared for questions about caring and access to services, but many were asking questions about other issues completely unrelated to their caring responsibilities that they were passionate about. And it struck me that that is actually some of what the Young Carers Festival is about, allowing young people to get into things that interest them. And it was an enlightening experience, even if they absolutely put me through my paces and challenged my policy knowledge. If anyone does get the chance to go, you absolutely should. I'd also like to take the opportunity to shine the light on some of the incredible work across Central Scotland aimed at benefiting young carers. At the Falkirk and Clackmannanshire Carers Centre, the organisation offers support tailored to the needs of young carers aged 8 to 18. This includes a support group with monthly sessions providing young carers with the rest from their caring responsibilities and the chance to connect with peers who understand their experiences. In North and South Lanarkshire, North and South Lanarkshire young carers are dedicated to supporting the experiences of young carers across the region. Their mission involves raising awareness, identifying and offering direct support to those who care for family members with illness or disability, including those caring for parents with mental health or substance abuse issues. I'd like to extend my very best wishes to all those involved in this year's Young Carers Action Day and their endeavours. Young Carers Action Day serves as an important reminder of the invaluable contributions young carers make in our communities and to their families, and the urgent need for support and recognition of their vital role. Together, we must amplify their voices, champion their rights, and work tirelessly towards a more inclusive and supportive society where every young carer feels valued and empowered.
Thank you, Ms Mackay. I now call Elena Whittam to be followed by Christine Groom. Ms Whittam.
Thank you, Deputy Presiding Officer, and may I too thank my colleague Karen Adam for bringing this important debate to the Chamber. But can I also extend my heartfelt gratitude to all of our young carers, the length and breadth of Scotland, including those from South and East Ayrshire and my Carrick, Cumnock and Doon Valley constituency, some of whom are in the gallery today. Thank you all. I first met the young people from the South Ayrshire Young Carers back in June when I attended a screening of their brilliant short film entitled The Weekend at South Ayrshire County Buildings. Now, I have always been in awe at the resilience, the determination and the love shown by our young carers. But, Presiding Officer, nothing prepared me for how blown away I was by both the film itself, but also by the young people when they took the time to explain to me how the film came about and also gave me an insight into their daily lives. I came away totally humbled and determined to help amplify their voices in this place. And I'm really delighted with the success with their young carer awareness-raising film has garnered. Initially only intended for local use, this film is now raising awareness of young carers right across Scotland and the UK. And I was very impressed to learn that the film was entirely co-produced, with the young carers starring in, writing, producing and directing it. And a big thanks to the local social enterprise film company, The Iris, and to South Ayrshire Council for recognising the value of co-production. It empowers in a way that simply telling a story cannot do. It is a very poignant and thought-provoking illustration of the life of young carers through their own eyes. The film tells the story of three young people as they navigate their lives and their caring roles over a single weekend. Importantly, this film contains a story on parental substance use, which they have been praised for including. And I hope that this will help to challenge the persistent stigma and also encourage children and young people in this situation to come forward for support as a young carer. The film has since achieved several accolades, including winning the Scottish Public Services Award for Diversity and Inclusion and winning the Scotland and North East England Regional Final of the Great British Care Awards in the unpaid carer category. They're heading to the UK finals later this month, and I'm sure the Chamber will join with me in wishing them the very, very best of luck. They are also finalists in the Youth Link Scotland Awards later this year for equality and diversity. Importantly, the film is now included in continuous professional development learning modules for Education Scotland and Carers Trust Scotland. This has really helped to raise the profile of young carers locally and nationally. Through their work with schools, the film supports young people to self-identify as young carers to ensure that they get the support to achieve equity, and that their peers actually gives them an insight into what the life and everyday experiences of young carers are, challenging assumptions and improving peer understanding. I think that that is absolutely vital. The authenticity from co-production and the pioneering content have also produced a resource which is changing the lives of children and families right across the country. I will see if I can get the film shared with MSPs because as the legislators of the land, it is important that we hear directly from young people ourselves. And excitingly, they are now working with primary age children to make a film suitable for their age and stage, with the young people involved in The Weeknd and now involved in this new project as peer mentors. I think that's just amazing. Finally, Presiding Officer, in terms of support nationally for young carers, the young people themselves told me about how important it is to have protected funding for young carers at a local level and for the young carer training to be made mandatory for education and social work alongside that statutory child protection training that they get. They need to be seen, they need to be heard, and they need to be supported. And we need to actively demonstrate that we care for the carers and that we all have a responsibility to ensure that these young people are supported in their caring roles. But they're also supported just to be kids. And this means recognising what supports need to be put in place to truly provide that equity that then gives them real equality and a fair future. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Whittam. And I now call Christine Graham. Ms. Graham.
Thank you, Deputy Presiding Officer. As usual, I had a technological blip. I don't know why I do this to myself. I congratulate my colleague on securing this debate, and it's a privilege to speak in it. I do indeed welcome young carers here today. There are around 1 million young carers aged 17 or under in the UK, and if we extrapolate on population numbers, that means approximately 100,000 young carers in Scotland, and I'm sure this is an underestimate. And at this stage in the debate, Deputy Presiding Officer, and to colleagues in the gallery, I apologise for the duplication of any points made, but they deserve repeating. So who is a young carer? And that's tricky, because many looking after adults in the family or siblings would not identify themselves as a carer. And there are some, indeed, who may wish to keep quiet, perhaps for fear of interference from, say, social work. Now, young carers usually know who they are, but for public consumption, a young carer is someone under 18 who helps look after someone in their family or a friend who is ill, disabled, or misuses drugs or alcohol. They can also have emotional as well as practical caring responsibilities. The level of single-handed responsibility that's sometimes placed on young carers would be daunting, even for an adult. Cleaning, laundry, washing, food shopping, lifting, cooking, financial and practical management, withdrawing cash, paying bills, intimate care, washing, bathing, giving medication, sibling care, looking after a brother or sister, and so on. Often the condition of the person they care for is not obvious, so people don't think the young person needs help. I understand, too, why young carers do not want to be any different from their peers or draw attention to their caring role. Understandably, they may want to keep their identity as a carer at school or college separate from their caring role. They may feel they can't discuss it with their friends. They don't have an opportunity to share their story. They're worried about bullying. Indeed, as I've said, worried that the family might be split up and they themselves might be taken into care. They may want their caring to be kept a secret because they're embarrassed. Some young carers even look after more than one person and may have health issues of their own. Some start giving care at a very young age, and others can become carers overnight. Now, I looked at the Carers Trust Young Carers in Education Toolkit. I was once a teacher, and there's an important role which we've referred here to the role of education, but the class teacher. It's called a resource for identifying and supporting young carers. They can be distracted, for example, checking their phone, not for a trivial reason, but to check on the person they care for and that they're okay. They can become quiet and withdrawn. They get no time at home to study due to hectic or chaotic home life and come back to school with homework undone. Should the teacher be taking them to task or working out what's behind this? They feel pressured to remain in a caring role and not progress into further education, a division of their loyalties. Now, there is helpful guidance on the Scotland website for teachers, and the most important thing is to be aware. Notice the change in behaviour, perhaps, of one of your pupils and ask yourself what's at the back of this. And there's young carers awareness training for teachers, so important for practitioners, student teachers and probationers, so that they know the signs to look out for. And I think a key thing here is to change the narrative. Celebrate young carers and the valuable work they do. It is a positive to be a young carer, but important to be recognised for that. And there is, of course, a duty for local authorities, but I've not got time to go into it, but both Midlothian and Borders have guidance on their website for young carers. I want to finish with this bit. It's time we all came together to make a change and create a fair future for young carers. And the Young Carers Covenant, which I've read, will do exactly that. And that's why I've signed it. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms Graham. And I now call on Minister Marie Todd to respond to the debate. Around 7 minutes, please, Minister.
Thank you very much. I want to start by thanking Karen Adam for initiating this important debate regarding Young Carer Action Day, and to thank all of you for being here to discuss young carers and the vital contribution that they make to society. As so often, my colleague Karen Adam has absolutely brought to life, partly because of her own lived experience, and given us immense insights into the situation for young carers, and has used her lived experience to advocate for change. It is really powerful to hear your own story and the testimonies that you have shared. Young Carer Action Day, which took place yesterday, is a valuable annual event, not only because it puts a spotlight on the very important issues facing young carers, but it also allows us to hear directly from young carers. And in fact, we've got over 50 young carers here today in Parliament, learning about how they can create change and speaking about what they need from us as decision makers. Now, I heard firsthand at last year's Young Carer Festival how this year's theme of a fairer future for young carers is an absolutely crucial focus for many of them. They expressed both their excitement and their apprehension at looking forward and planning for their future. As I said in my opening, it's really important that Parliament has been given the opportunity to acknowledge the positive role that young carers play in our society and to reflect on some of the pressures that they face. Now, as part of this, we welcome the Young Carer Covenant, launched by Carers Trust as part of Young Carer Action Day. Committing to the Covenant will take a cross-government commitment, so I will absolutely commit now to engage with my ministerial colleagues about the Scottish Government signing up. And I'd encourage others who work with young carers to sign up too. The statements in the Covenant align with our policies and actions already in place to help recognise and support young carers, as set out in the Carers Scotland Act and our National Carers Strategy. And I'm very grateful for the opportunity to mention some of these actions that we're taking to support young carers to ensure that caring is not a barrier to them achieving their future goals. In 2022, we published our Scottish Government National Carers Strategy. Now into the second year of implementation, the strategy sets out our approach to addressing current issues facing all carers, as well as a long-term vision for building a sustainable future for young carers. Now, we recognise in the strategy that young carers' education and their future prospects are incredibly important, and that's why we fully fund an education officer at Carers Trust Scotland and will continue to work with education colleagues to ensure that young carers are seen and supported in schools. I agree with John Swinney and others about the flexibility and extra support that is needed for children and young people in education. And I agree with the point about raising awareness so that people self-identify as carers. We do have a Young Carers Identification Awareness Raising campaign. It runs around the Young Carers Festival and the Young Carers Action Day. But my own personal view is that the system needs to be just that little bit more automatic. That would solve a couple of problems. Very often, the person that these young people are caring for is well known to the system. It's very often a brother or sister who is also in the education system. why not automatically recognise and identify brothers and sisters as part of their care? Proactively offering them support means that we don't have to wait for them to identify themselves, and I'm keen to pursue that with education colleagues. As well as working with education colleagues, we've been working with Skills Development Scotland and employers with projects like Carers Positive to make sure that when young carers are ready to join the world of work, there continues to be flexibility and support for them. Many young carers tell us that they receive invaluable support from their local carer and young carer services. And that's why we fund the Coalition of Carers in Scotland and Carers Trust Scotland to support carer centres and young carer services to collaborate and to build capacity. Alongside their core local funding, we provided £560,000 in 23-24 for local carer centres to expand their support to carers, including young carers, and have provided £3.5 million specifically for short breaks. Being able to take a break as a young carer is absolutely key to ensuring that they get time to pursue their hobbies, manage their own well-being, and have other opportunities which can help to support them in their future goals. To reassure Gillian Mackay and others who raised this point, we will establish a right to breaks from caring through the National Care Service Bill to support people, to protect their well-being and to sustain those caring relationships. The bill will create a right to personalised breaks, support for any carer who isn't currently able to access sufficient breaks. But we're not waiting for the bill. We are acting now to expand the easy access short breaks ahead of that legislation. Now, as well as the Short Breaks Fund, we fund the Young Scot Young Carer Package and the annual Young Carer Festival to help young carers to have some form of break, pursue the opportunities and to have fun. Improving support for unpaid carers is an absolute priority for our social security powers, and despite our fixed budgets and our limited powers of devolution, we have transformed social security provision in Scotland, delivering a system based on our principles of dignity, fairness and respect. We want to ensure that caring isn't a barrier for young people. Certainly.
Mark Griffin.
I really appreciate the Minister giving way. I think the Young Carer Grant has been a fantastic addition to the social security landscape in Scotland. When the Minister talks about fairness, I think there is a slight unfairness in that eligibility where siblings or people in the same household need to choose between themselves who applies and qualifies for that Young Carer Grant, despite them both providing the same level of care. And I wonder if the Minister would give any consideration to extending that criteria just so slightly so that siblings in the same household could both qualify.
Minister.
So the member will be aware that the social security powers don't actually lie in my portfolio, but I am more than happy to raise that issue with colleagues. As I said, responding to young carers' needs is going to require a cross-government approach, and I'm more than happy to raise these issues and see what we can do to improve the situation. We want to ensure that caring is not a barrier for young people to succeed in life. Since 2019, we've invested around £3.3 million, making over 10,000 payments of our Young Carer Grant, which is unique to Scotland and provides young carers with an annual payment of over £350 to spend as they choose. That gives them direct control of how best to support themselves, allowing them to access life opportunities and activities which are more typical for their peers. Now, we recognise the importance of young carers having access to education, and our recently launched carer support payment expands access to many carers in full-time education who are currently unable to get carers allowance, benefiting up to 1,500 carers a year once the benefit's available nationally. We'll continue to engage with carers of all ages, including young carers, to inform future improvements to carer support payment. All this work I've just mentioned has been guided by young carers telling us what they need, and we will continue to listen to young carers to shape our work. To close, I want to acknowledge members' contributions today. It's been a really fabulous debate with the issues absolutely brought to life and lots of wonderful references to the young people in the gallery. Most importantly, I want to acknowledge the huge contribution that is being made by young carers right across Scotland, and I want to reiterate the Scottish Government's commitment to doing what we can to make sure that young carers have access to the support that they deserve when they need it. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Minister. That concludes the debate, and I suspend this meeting until 2:30 p.m. Thank you.